Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back. Brandon again. Wanted to make a quick video today to talk about an Ohio power bar in stainless steel and compare it to that of one in black zinc. And I got this idea for this video as I was down here taking pictures of my knurling on a new bar that I got. Yes, I'm that guy. It got me to thinking. Normally when I show you knurling pictures, or knurl porn, as they've become to be called, I typically only talk about a single bar at a time, just showing you what the knurl's like, or I compare it to companies that aren't in the same kind of league, meaning that I'll compare an Ohio power bar to a Texas power bar. So the neural patterns aren't exactly identical and it's not really an apples to apples comparison. In this case, I want to compare two of the same versions of a bar with just different finishes on it and talk a little bit about what those finishes can potentially do. So in this case, we're going to be using a black zinc and a stainless steel bar. Using black zinc, first of all, because I find that this is the most popular version of the Ohio power bar. It's the first finish that I bought at the time. It also tends to be one of the most affordable ones at $285. So it's just $20 more than the bare steel version. And I find most people shy away from bare steel because they're afraid of the maintenance or upkeep it might require. And then you have the stainless steel version, which is the most expensive version of the bar. This one is $395. And it's also the most resistant to oxidation that's out there. So the black zinc one is very resistant to oxidation. Stainless steel is the most resistant. So this is the most popular version. This is the most desired version, I think. However, it just goes beyond oxidation resistance, and I'll talk about that more in a second. It also has to deal with what the bar feels like, which is also something that can be potentially really important. And if you watched a couple years ago, the first video I made on the Ohio power bar, it was a black zinc bar. That was the first version that I bought. Most popular, as I've already said. And at the time, there was only black zinc and bare steel. And at the time, I said the black zinc was probably the better buy because $20 more and more resistance. But what I didn't really realize is over time that that black zinc is going to fade and rub away and not only make discolorations on the bar, but also leave it open to oxidation more frequently. So it doesn't last very long, which many of you out there can attest to. And interestingly enough, it wasn't until I was in a commercial gym that had a heavily used black zinc bar that was almost completely missing the black zinc that I realized, wow, this bar feels a lot better than my bar. And it was because the black zinc was no longer there. So resistance to oxidation is one point. Feel of the bar is the other point. Right now, if you were asking me what's the best Ohio power bar for you to get, I would say stainless. Number one, because it offers the most resistance to oxidation. And number two, outside of bare steel, it offers the best feel. So the feel of the knurl is kind of tied between the bare steel and stainless steel, with the winner to me being the stainless because I don't have to clean it hardly ever versus a bare steel bar, which might potentially take a lot of upkeep. So the resistance is going to really vary on where you guys live and how much oxidation you could potentially see. If you take a look at Rogue's offering, they give you a chart for oxidation and it basically goes bare steel, phosphate, chrome, black zinc, E-coat, Cerakote, and then stainless steel. Not surprisingly enough, as you go to the more resistant finishes, you're also talking about being more and more expensive. So if resistance to oxidation isn't something that's as important to you, a bare steel bar for $265 is a fantastic deal, and you don't need to spend $400 on a stainless steel version just because it's more resistance, because that's not going to give you any benefit necessarily. Now, when it comes to the other finishes though, there's other things to talk about, and that is the feel of the bar itself. As I said already, the bare steel and stainless steel feel the best, and that's because those are the only two which the applications don't actually fill in the knurl. So when you talk about things like phosphate or chrome or black zinc or E-coat or Cerakote, you're talking about adding in another layer, applying another finish on top of the metal itself, which is going to fill in all those crevices of that nice, naughty knurling that we've been talking about and I've been feeling all video long. In fact, I want to show you some close-up of these two bars itself so you can actually get an idea. Now, to the untrained eye, these probably look very similar. That's because they are. They are the same knurl pattern. But what you can probably notice is on the stainless version, everything's much more crisp and precise versus the black zinc version, which is a little bit more dulled. And that's because things are filled in, the knurl isn't going to be as deep, and the actual edges aren't going to be as pronounced, which when you come to grip is going to play a bigger role. So it translates very, very well. Now for some bars, and depending on how you lift, this might not matter. If you're doing a little bit of everything in your gym and you're not pulling heavy weight or you're not doing deadlifts or squats where you need the bar to stick on your back, probably not going to make that much of a difference. But for a lot of people who want to invest in a power bar, when you're talking about spending $300 minimum after shipping and tax, to me, I'd want to get the best feeling of the bar as possible. And that's why, again, I tend to stay away from finishes that fill in that knurling. So Quick comparisons between the two. Just wanted to bring that to your attention if you're out there looking for a bargain. That's not to say that you should shy away from the Black Zinc or a Cerakote or an E-Coat. I still think overall they're fantastic bars, but I do think the stainless steel is worth the money, especially when you consider it's not a finish that's going to wear off. It's going to be something that's extremely resistant to oxidation, which means that over the course of a year, you don't have to clean your bar every week or every other week. You're gonna save yourself a ton of time. It'll pay for itself really, really quickly. And to me, it also looks the best. And again, for someone who's lazy, less upkeep is great and one of the best feels of the bar itself outside of bare steel. So let me know in the comment section below which one you bought or which one you would buy if you had to pay for it. And if you have any other questions, leave them there as well. In the meantime, as always, thanks for watching and stay big.